وجاءوا على قميصه بدم كذب قال بل سولت لكم أنفسكم أمرا فصبر جميل والله المستعان على ما تصفون.
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين والصلاة والسلام على أشرف الأنبياء والمرسلين. الحمد لله الذي خلق السماوات والأرض وجعل الظلمات والنور، وصلى الله وسلم وبارك على خير الأنام سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه ومن سار على نهجهم الدين. Praise be to Allah, the creator and owner of life, and blessing upon his last messenger Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم. My dear respected brothers, today's topic is something that when you look through the internet or listen to a lot of tapes, we find out how important it is and how highly it is recommended within the Muslims, within Islam, for the Muslims to be patient. But as soon as they give the brief intro, as I'm late, as soon as they give the brief intro, it would be a different sabr that I wanted to cover today, other than the usual that we listen to the shuyukh. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the Quran says, وَاصْبِرُوا إِنَّ اللَّهَ مَعَ الصَّابِرِينَ. Also Allah says in another verse, be patient indeed, Allah is with the patient. And then Allah also says in another verse, وَاللَّهُ يُحِبُّ الصَّابِرِينَ. That Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala loves, you know, servants who preserve and always are patient. And also in another verse Allah says, إِنَّمَا يُوَفَّى الصَّابِرِينَ أَجْرُهُمْ بِغَيْرِ حِسَابٍ. That Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will reward those who always observe patience with an ultimate reward, which is no accountability to it. It's not something that is measurable or something that is tangible. And this is the reward for it. And usually, when we listen to our shuyukh, they'll speak also from the examples of the prophets and from the prophet and the nation that were before us. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the Quran, when Sayyidina Musa alayhi salatu wasalam said to his people, قَالَ مُوسَى لِقَوْمِهِ
اسْتَعِينُوا بِاللَّهِ وَاصْبِرُوا إِنَّ الْأَرْضَ لِلَّهِ يُورِثُهَا مَنْ يَشَاءُ مِنْ عِبَادِهِ وَالْعَاقِبَةُ لِلْمُتَّقِينَ.
That Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, Sayyidina Musa in this verse, Surah Al-A'raf, that Allah says to Musa, on Musa saying that seek help in Allah. So when you are in difficulties or you need help, you go to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and be patient straight away with the help. Instead, when you seek the help from Allah, and then be patient. Verily, the earth is to Allah, and He gives it as a heritage to whom He wills, of His slaves and the blessed ones. فَالْعَقِبَةُ لِلْمُتَّقِينَ, and the blessed ones. And here we have to remember, there is also from the Sayyidina Ibrahim alayhi salam, for example, that he used to make dua to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, so he blessed him with what? With a child. And imagine, after all these years, he gets blessed by Sayyidina Ismail. And then, after all this, the iman, the tawheed, the yaqeen that he has, the compassionate with Allah, and knowing how Allah is strong in his belief, that he stills Allah tests him more and gives him another difficult trial when he tells him to actually slaughter or to say to his own son. Can someone do it? It's unimaginable. What kind of test one of the prophets, Sayyidina Ibrahim, has to go through in order to see what kind of patience he would show? And the greater patience also is from Sayyidina Ismail himself, when he says to Prophet Ibrahim alayhi salatu wasalam, Ya Abati fa'al ma tu'mar, satajiduni insha'allahu min as-sabirin. Oh my dad, do what you've been commanded, and you will find me of those who are patient. This is, imagine, someone has been worshipping Allah to be blessed with another, with a child, and then when you have one, Allah bless you with one, that is still saying another trial. And this is the believers, this is the mu'min, those who believe in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, they'll go through different trials. But there is a hadith of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam that will lead me to the topic that I want to cover today, which is the hadith of Ibn Umar ibn Khattab رضي الله عنه. المؤمن قال الرسول صلى الله عليه وسلم المؤمن الذي يخالط الناس ويصبر على أذاهم أعظم أجرا من المؤمن الذي لا يخالط الناس ولا يصبر على أذاهم. The believer who mixes with people of who? Of normal life, to do his own affairs on daily life, and endures their harms, so harms becomes his way, and he's a believer, is better and is greater before the eyes of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, those who are a believer, but doesn't mix and feel to go on isolated on his own ways without mixing. This hadith, that would lead me to the main area that I would like to cover today, which is the being patient with our brothers, all brothers in our own houses, being patient with our own sisters, being patient with our own wives. And inshallah, as we give the examples, you will see how far we are from patient, although patient in our own eyes should be the main tool to worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. In fact, they are twin. If you talk about patience, it's a straightaway victory equal to patience, patience equal to victory. If you want to be victorious in your life, you want to be victorious against your enemy, if you want victorious in your own da'wah work, if you want to have the fruitness out of it, wallahi, be patient. Because don't expect to be thankful from the people or from your enemy, from those who loves you or don't love you. Be patient and do it for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And some of the examples that we give, although it might be a bit of a joke, but when somebody is about to get married, and during the engagement period, that a brother, this is a true story, so it's not something to make it up, that during, you know, because there is love and there is the wonderland and where they think and the theme and so forth, they will start to think, they will tell his future wife, shall we say, that he will tell her, can you please read Al-Baqarah, read Surah Al-Imran, read this. So this brother said to me that before marriage, because they were so patient that inshallah they were in difficulty and hardship, but they were still, they knew they belonged to each other, and they were asking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala inshallah to make it happen for them. So he was asking her, please can you memorize Allah, she did. And then he told her, for the sake of Allah, can you memorize Surah Al-Baqarah? She memorized the whole of Surah Al-Baqarah. And then he tells her, can you please memorize Surah Al-Imran? And then she memorized Surah Al-Imran. But unfortunately, after they got married, he said, the brother, she didn't even manage to memorize one ayah. And the reason is because the life that they were expecting of one another is to be like the prophets. Everything has to be perfected. And the reality is, we're human beings. And when we deal with one another closer than when further from each other, that we find the real person. And the real person obviously has a lot of shortcomings. And then obviously, how can you teach me to memorize the Quran? How can you ask me when you're not an example? And someone should always bring again to be patient with their husbands. And remember, it could be a reason for da'wah. Even wallahi if they're drinking, even wallahi if they're clubbing, even if they're raving, let's not live the false life. The reality is, people will do something wrong. And sometimes they deviate from the straight path. But if you show that level of being patient, and that you do the da'wah for the sake of Allah, Allah will bring them. In fact, sometimes you find a person who is quite patient but can't speak English. And you find them every day, 3-4 days, bringing a new Muslim or a new sister to Islam. And it happens in real life. Again, with your own brother. Why would your brother not accept your own da'wah or your own advice? Your own brother. Same blood, same house, same roof, same father, same mother, but will not accept a sincere advice from you. Because we become so harsh and harm, instead of showing and demonstrating a contentment with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has written, that person can be a test for us, and therefore that we have to preserve and show greater example of patience, so we could see that his action, it doesn't upset me, but if I hate the action, it's not hate the person, and it's only done for the sake of Allah. And this is in many, many houses. That you see so many brothers, mashallah, they're very good examples outside. Do you see them, mashallah, they quite handsome, well-dressed, mashallah, looking after themselves. And when they come to their own houses, the first thing they need to remember is, do everything under this flag, the flagship of being patient. And the other thing is that I want, that also Umar ibn al-Khattab has said, the second companion, radiallahu anhu, that he said, الصَّبْرُ بِالْيَقِينِ, that sabr has to come with yaqeen. Yaqeen, it means that you have full conviction, full iman, full trust in what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. For instance, if somebody told you today that what's happening to the Muslim ummah everywhere, divorce in the families, fighting among brothers, partners are and getting in dispute and so forth, the ummah is scattered everywhere, Palestine is in crisis, Egypt is chaos, everywhere we say this, And asked you completely, do you have the full belief that al-mustaqbal Islam, that the future is for this deen? What would your answer be? Everything against you, tangible, real, that you touch on, is against what you think. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is part of a Muslim, part of a believer, to think 110% that the future, yaqeenan, that the future belongs to Islam. This kind of faith when you have, then you start to believe why I should be a good faithful, a true believer, why I should preserve patient, why I should be trustworthy when I'm doing my dealings, when I'm wearing my hijab, why I should be a good sister, and making sure that that being an ambassador to Islam could be for the way I dress or the way I speak, and also the way I deal with other people. And to patient, when if Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give you a test for your mom or your sister or even a brother who's a weaver, and then his family is, I hate to hear brothers when they say, when tell them, oh, my dad has died, and they say, yeah, dad is a kafir, and they will say in that terms. Wallahi, they say it with greater hatred. And when we should know as Muslims, especially the status for our parents, is greater almost, وَصَيْنَ الْإِنسَانَ بِوَلِدِهِ, it comes straight after Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala commands us to worship Him, that there's no one worthy but Allah, and then the respect and the obedience to parents. So that leniency goes with the patient, hopefully will result to inshallah to make it better. There's three levels of patience. I could even say the fourth one, to be thankful. But the number one is, as soon as some harms come your way, or a test or trials or tribulation comes toward you, in different ways, it could be through your business, through your work, through someone that you know. It could be so many ways that Allah can test you. And it depends obviously on the iman of that person. You could be a gifted a child and then he passed away. You could have a mom and she's very generous and kind and she passed away. Or a brother that will pass early. And then you start questioning yourself, why is it him? Why is the bad person who's drunk outside the street shouldn't be dying and not a Muslim? In Islam, no, you should be patient. Number one is to actually curse the whole things and to think this is not acceptable. This is why Allah is doing this. Just by saying this, you've already came out, you perform it haram. Straight away, number one, you should be patient. Straight away, if I move on to number two now, is to have the same patient, but you still think, why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has done it. You still accept it. You accept it and you preserve it, but you're not grateful, you're not thankful. So if you move on to the next one, actually happens and you accept it as it is. And you say, oh, alhamdulillah. Alhamdulillah, this happens, and this is when you are thankful, which is the highest status of sabr, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will 110% surely will reward you in His own ways. And in His own ways, mean that it's not something that you could work it or you could touch it or tangible. It could be harm that was coming your own ways, that Allah makes it, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will make it less harmful. And this is why in dunya, we look at someone who is what? In dunya, who do we look at someone? Someone who is lower than us. Always something to do with dunya, with this life. Somebody who is a doctor. You don't need to say, oh, I need to be a doctor, I need to be this. You could be inspired, but no. In hereafter, it's the opposite. Who do you look after? You look up to someone who is better than you. For instance, if somebody gives £100 or £10 or £5, you look at somebody who is better than you if you don't give anything. If you pray jama'ah 5 times, you look at somebody who does even the witr, or even do the qiyam, or he does the lectures, or he does dua, or he does memorize the Quran. In something to do with the hereafter, you always look at someone who is better than you, and this is how you perfect yourself. In the dunya, you look at somebody who is lower than you, you look at the miskin, you look at somebody who is maybe with one leg, or one eye, one hand, and is still blessed to be able to worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So the one that I mentioned, number one is, really not to be grateful and to be down and not to accept what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has written for him. Number two, to accept it, but still, you know, still not 100% justified, like why me? And the worst of all of this is what is clearly forbidden in Islam, near to the first one, which is somebody hitting or slapping, you know, at each other or even waving. And these are the extremes. And from that you will see even why sometimes women in Islam, they don't even go to the grave and so on, because the way they grieve, sometimes the extreme, unless the sister has an iman, and the brothers who are around, they can always remind her of that. And obviously the best of all of this is the person who will, thankful to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, And therefore, because he's grateful and thankful to Allah, Allah will increase what? Will increase his iman and he will increase his reward. One of the things that I will touch, which is again a true story, that sometime we have some brothers or sisters that will do mistakes. And this is in real life, not somebody told me. His daughter will do something that is wrong, and then he will use an iron to touch her, to hurt them. So it becomes so harmful. And there is a difference in Islam between a punishment and between what? What do you call it? If you want to punish somebody or you want to remind somebody. You want to tell somebody, look, watch out, what you've done is wrong. And sometimes to the extreme, in this country maybe they call it child abuse, so we take it to the extreme. But in reality is, if let's say a child, you're telling them to do something, don't do this. And then that child will do exactly what you told them don't do. What's your reaction is? If your reaction is, oh, and give a proper slap, that is now an excessive tool of punishment. But if somebody did it and you're in control, but you still punish that child, but with some wisdom, but it could be like write something or do something, but something that justifies the punishment. Anything that is with anger, and that's why Prophet Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam said, لا تغضب لا تغضب لا تغضب. You know what does it mean, لا تغضب? Does anyone know what does it mean? لا تغضب. It means don't be what? Huh? Huh? Angry, well done, mashallah. Only one? The rest don't know? What does la taghdab mean? I'm going to run it now like a classroom now. I'm going to start asking questions. So either you're sleeping or I'm sleeping. What does it mean? What does... Okay, huh? La taghdab means? Is it correct? Tayyib, mashallah. So everybody's shaking. They all wake, huh? Tayyib. The other thing is as well, that some of our brothers and sisters, when they do in da'wah, They expect from the other side, whoever is accepting it, to be patient, and they don't look at themselves. And here the example that I want to give is, I remember a brother who wanted to do, you know, when Prophet Muhammad was criticized, but he was attacked and he was insulted. And for the Muslim woman reaction then, it could have been one of two. Either we educate the other side or we react, which goes beyond the patient that we're meant to see. And if we find the Muslim Ummah to be in a weak position, the reaction not to really just to do something negative that will raise hostile and so forth. And so in our own ways, we should have really demonstrated maybe more patience by saying, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, it said in the Quran, inna nahnu nazzalna dhikra wa nahnu, that we indeed have revealed the revelation and we will look after it. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So we're only there for reasons. So if this happens again in this life, in while we are alive, what we have to make sure is, everyone in his own house, you first will educate your brothers and sisters in your house, and your children if you're a father, or your mom and your dad and so forth, how we should be really reacting to that. Number one, wallahi brothers, if you want victory, you have to be patient. Prophet Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam did not go and did his da'wah 13 years in secrets just for the sake of doing it like that. The years that he spent to do it in secret is to build the ummah that accept and should have the tawheed, yes, the aqeedah in their hearts and its soul and its blood, but at the same time to have patience when it's been tested. And this is why the verse that I've read when Sayyidina Musa said, استعينوا بالله واصبروا إن الأرض لله يورثها من يشاء من عباده والعاقبة للمتقين. He's saying this after what? After the test of Fir'aun. What did Fir'aun do to them? The punishment they took, the hand that he managed, or the arms that he managed to chop, the threat, the even to the extent that they had no one else to turn to but Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. What a severe test they had. But look at the reply from Sayyidina Musa alayhi salam, the reply of the Prophet, of the people of Allah. His reply is what? Seek help in Allah and be patient. This is the first. Because he knows equal to that is victorious. And even when the magicians, the companion has differences in terms of, they said their iman, their belief. These magicians were, it was the most extreme. But only for Prophet Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam hadith that says, لَوُضِعَ إِيمَانُ أَبُو بَكْرٍ فِي كَفَّةٍ ووضع إيمان أمتي في كفة لرجح إيمان أبو بكر الصديق. That if Abu Bakr al-Siddiq, the first خليفة, the trustworthy خليفة of the believers, if his إيمان has been put in one scale, and the whole أمة إيمان in another scale, It would, which one would weigh up? Is the iman of Khalifa Abu Bakr Siddiq. The mufassirun, those who interpret the Quran and translate and put the tafsir, they've said the people of the magicians that they believed in Musa, their iman was so great near to the iman of Abu Bakr Siddiq. And the reason is because they know the tools they were using. And as soon as Musa did his own, what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has commanded them to do, they knew this is something not a human can create. They knew this is something beyond what a human being can. Therefore, their iman, straight away they bow down, straight to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and straight away, Fir'aun, la'anahullah, and that he straight away threatened them. Why? Because of what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the test. If they failed that test, when they could have lost everything in life. As Iblis, na'aratullahi alayh, has... I'm not going to take much longer than this. I've got the person who threatened me on a regular basis here next to me. But in reality, I would advise all the brothers and sisters, even if you have an imam who leads longer, be patient with him. If an imam recites or a lecturer who takes longer than, be patient. Wallahi, simple things that perfect it. And عَسَىٰ أَن تُحِبُّ شَيْئًا وَعَسَىٰ أَن تَكْرُوا شَيْئًا وَهُوَ خَيْرٌ لَكُمْ أَيْضًا عَسَىٰ أَن تُحِبُّ شَيْئًا وَهُوَ شَرٌ لَكُمْ. That do not dislike something that might be beneficial to you, and do not hate something that might be. So as a Muslim, remember, the key for you today, to the days that are coming, and inshallah they take home with you, is be patient in everything that you do, because it's equal to what?
Victory.
Equal to what? To victory. If you want to be successful in your life, in your education, in everything you do, be patient. جزاكم الله خير. وأسأل الله سبحانه وتعالى أن نكون من الصابرين الرابحين الناجحين الساجدين. أسأل الله سبحانه وتعالى أن يدخلكم الجنة وأن يبارك لكم فيما تقدمون. وأسأل الله سبحانه وتعالى أن يجعل هذا الجمع جمعا مباركا. آمين يا رب العالمين.
جزاكم الله خير أستاذ خالد. Just a reminder that we often make during MQE's previous years is that these nights are indeed nights of importance, whereby we try to gain as much reward as we can. And sometimes we have to remember that the dua, the hadith of Prophet ﷺ, when he said that the angels, they roam the earth looking for a halaq of dhikr, gatherings of remembrance of Allah. And when they find it, Allah asks them, what are they doing, what have they gathered for? And they say, I'm paraphrasing this, that they have gathered for you to remember you, Allah. And the hadith goes on to say that they do this for the sake of earning your paradise. And then Allah, near the end of the hadith, says that bear witness that I forgive them, all of them. But in the hadith, they also mentioned that there's a man, the angel said, well, what about this man who came, he didn't intend to come to this gathering, but he just happened to pass by and he took seat in this gathering. And then Allah said, my mercy is such that I even forgive him as well. So inshallah, Allah make us this gathering and any gathering that we take place for the sake of Allah, of those where we earn his forgiveness as well. So see this as well as a form of worship. Never, you know, that's why I mentioned the other nights, you know, when we're learning from people that have come here, we should have the etiquette to learn and realize that this is also ibadah. That learning itself is ibadah. Ibn Hanbal, he mentions that after all the fara'id, that he says that the best worship after that is not jihad. Other scholars say it's jihad, but he himself says learning for the for the sake of Allah. So this we should keep in our mind. Other thing that we should do is that there's a reason we put buckets downstairs. We've got about three buckets. One is to donate to this program itself, which will, you know, facilitates this, and it requires at least about £3,000. So also just to provide the food and so forth. So if you can donate there, and realize that donation is also a form of ibadah. Allah says in a hadith of Qudsi that Allah says, O son of Adam, spend and I shall spend on you. So even if our finances is low, that's the best time to give of sadaqah, because we should expect Allah to then be giving us in reward as payment as well. So that form is always kept there. We're also raising money for Gaza. We haven't decided which charity we'll be using, but it will be one of the mainstream charities that is on the ground there, most probably Interpower. And we also have a bucket there that we, on every year, we collect to build a well. So we've had two wells now over the years where we are building for the audience itself. So the plaque actually says, if you go to the website, our website, you'll see it there. The plaque says from the audience of LQE, and it was 2012 and 2013. And inshallah, this year also we are trying to raise. It's about £650. So if you do donate, please do donate there. With that, I'll just... Yeah, sure. Before I pass it back on to Khalid to wrap up, when we do finish, please, Brother Habib over there has the suhoor tickets. If you can please collect the tickets to ensure that you have suhoor. We've only got a limited number of suhoor, so what that does is that makes us realize how, you know, if you don't have suhoor, then you will know that, okay, I don't have a suhoor ticket, so I must make my own arrangements. But so please try to get your suhoor ticket from him so that we can guarantee you some suhoor after the Hajj.
Sorry, just that, because just reminded me about Gaza. And I know as young people, many of them, they think alike, and they think, and I said this to where we pray, why should we build and they destroy? Somebody might just be fed up that we build and they destroy. We build and they destroy. We build and we destroy. And I just touched a few seconds ago about the yaqeen, to have yaqeen in your heart, in your mind, that the future belongs to Islam. That's one of the requirements to be a believer. But what we have to remember is, just by building what they destroy, it's a message, wallahi, a strong message, to those who don't want that to happen. Because the whole thing is to lose the appetite for, to help your brothers and sisters. This is what they want you to be. To stay aside, step aside and leave your house and go somewhere else and build a tent, that's what they're looking for. So even to that, in its own wallahi jihad, in its own patient, and these brothers and sisters, they must have been blessed by, from the number of hadiths that we read about the people of Palestine, inshallah there'll be those who are being chosen there in the many, many hadiths. And wallahi, to give as little as you can. You don't know how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will multiply and how He will complement it when it gets there. Then your intention is as important. And for those who doubt, there is a verse in the Quran that says, الَّذِينَ قَالَ لَهُمُ النَّاسِ. Those believers, some hypocrite who tell them, الَّذِينَ قَالَ لَهُمُ النَّاسِ إِنَّ النَّاسَ قَدْ جَمَعُوا لَكُمْ فَخْشَوْهُمْ فَزَادَهُمْ إِيمَانًا وَقَالُوا حَسْبُنَا اللَّهُ وَنِعْمَ الْوَكِيلُ. الَّذِينَ قَالَ لَهُمُ النَّاسِ إِنَّ النَّاسَ قَدْ جَمَعُوا لَكُمْ فَخْشَوْهُمْ فَزَادَهُمْ إِيمَانًا وَقَالُوا حَسْبُنَا اللَّهُ وَنِعْمَ الْوَكِيلُ. The meaning of this verse is, those to whom the people said, now they're saying it to the believers, look what they've said, إِنَّ النَّاسَ قَدْ جَمَعُوا لَكُمْ, that verily the people have gathered against you. Verily, fear them. لَكُمْ فَخْشَوْهُمْ, fear them. فَزَادَهُمْ إِيمَانًا, look what happened, but it increased them in Iman. Instead of fearing, seeing everybody gathered against them, it actually had the opposite implication, which is to increase their Iman. And then what the Muslim meant to say, and this is something that I forgot to touch on, that Allah alone is sufficient for us. Remember this, Allah alone, hasbunallahu wa ni'mal wakeel, that Allah alone is sufficient for us, and He is the best disposer of our affairs. This is what he says, hasbunallahu wa ni'mal wakeel. There is no better reply that you could give than hasbunallahu wa ni'mal wakeel. Can we all say it one more, please? Hasbunallahu wa ni'mal wakeel. Remember this, take it to your brother, take it to your sister, take it to your wife, take it to those who you know. Wallahi, if you take this from the talk of today, you've got some great, great tool to, inshallah, to enable you to live the life that Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam wants it for us, and the way that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has commanded us to worship with. وجزاكم الله خير.